How do you like the sound of this? Grass that stays green, and you don't even have to water it.
That's always nice. Eileen's on the back patio with OodleBoxTV.com. So how does it work?
You know, I'm surprised at how soft it feels. It's basically just a synthetic thing, and it's Tuffgrass. That's what it's called. And Paul Costas here from Tuffgrass, part of OodleBoxTV, to show us all the steps needed to put this down in your yard. Yeah, you don't have to water it or mow it. Does it get any better?
Again. No, actually, it really is ideal, Eileen. It's really true. You know, we've been around for almost 11 years now, installing exclusively synthetic grass and tough grass.
And how did you start this?
Actually, my wife and I started this, and thank you for the question. my wife was looking for a putting green for me. And I've been golfing for about 25 years. I'm absolutely horrible, but I love the sport.
But you've made a good little business out of this, and a smart business, especially in times of water shortages.
Yes,
everybody's restricted now in terms of watering their lawns to certain days and all that, and this just negates the whole problem completely. So
absolutely.
How does it work?
Absolutely. You know, what I wanted to do here is set up kind of like a little display.
Yeah, so this is what it would look like in your yard about 6 inches
exactly,
down.
Exactly, exactly. You know, depending on your soil conditions will determine the depth of base that needs to go underneath the grasses themselves.
Okay.
So if you're in Roseville area, you have clay, Granite Bay, Folsom areas,
right.
There's a lot of clay in the soil type.
Right.
So what we'll do, we'll actually excavate a little bit deeper, put a deeper layer of the crushed rock base.
Okay.
Now, tough grass drains like a natural grass does.
Huh.
So it's completely porous. And then what ends up happening is that it will, you see we have the drainage holes in there.
Oh, okay.
And then it also leaches through the stitch line. And so, again, your soil conditions will determine how much base needs to go underneath that, so when we do get our 100-year rain, that we're not flooding in your backyard.
Right.
Now, the last step to the process, which is probably one of the most important parts of the process, is a product called Superfill.
Uh-huh.
Now, what Superfill is an acrylic-coated sand. And what that does is that's the ballast. So that helps hold the grasses down to the ground,
mm-hmm.
helps hold the blades up themselves,
mm-hmm.
and it gives you a cushion when you're walking on it.
So it's soft, so it feels like the
exactly,
dirt would give.
Exactly, exactly. So the nice thing about Superfill also is that it's the football fields, most of the stadiums, you know, these are where all these grasses started, was in, you know,
yeah,
was in pro
artificial
sports.
Artificial turf, yeah.
Exactly. You know, when people think, you know, still after 40-plus years, people think of synthetic turf, and they think AstroTurf.
Right.
And, you know, AstroTurf was a nylon blade, very abrasive, actually installed on concrete.
Yeah, this doesn't feel anything like that.
Exactly, exactly. So what we were very, very fortunate to do is work directly with the folks that make the yarn itself.
Uh-huh.
And so this is like our spec, our blend, our mm-hmm. brand of actual synthetic grass.
Okay, is this just Superfill? Different kinds, different colors?
Different colors, basically. The only other difference too here, Eileen, is the size. Like the green is a what we call a 1630 mesh in the mm-hmm. in the sand world. It's a finer sand. We use that mainly when we do synthetic putting greens.
Okay. And then you go up from here in different kind of soil types.
Yeah, exactly. You know, again, the Superfill is, again, for the ballast to help hold it down, lift it up. It's, for color-wise, it's more of an aesthetic thing.
Right. So what's the kind of maintenance? You saw me earlier, guys, combing. I mean, literally, you don't cut this, you comb it. Okay, so what's the maintenance on this?
Basically,
how long will it last?
That's two great questions. Maintenance-wise, it's a leaf blower. If it gets dusty, you rinse it off. And that is literally
ridiculous.
It. You know,
okay.
We've done lots of dog resorts. That's the kind of the new trend is these dog resorts for folks who still are fortunate enough to travel. And it's one of those things where we've done tens of thousands of square feet for dogs.
Okay, we got to go, but quickly, cost per square?
Cost per square foot, average, fully installed. What we've been very fortunate is not to change our pricing over the last 10 years. Approximately $10 to $14 a square foot installed.
Perfect. Tuffgrass. Paul, thanks for joining us today. We're going to be back tomorrow, starting at 7 a.m., actually 6 a.m. right here on My 58.